Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Bande Guru Paramparam Om Bhadram Karne Vishrunuyavadevaha Bhadram Pashe Makshabhiryajatraha Stirirangai Stushtavagum Sastadubhihi Vyashema Devahi Dayadayuhu Swastina Indro Vriddhashravaha Swastina Pusha Vishvavedaha Swastina Starkshyo Arishtanemihi Swastino Brahaspatir Dadhatu Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. To discover that I am that absolute Ananda, I have to experience relative Ananda. Otherwise, we don't know what the Upanishad is talking about. To know that I am that absolute Shanti, I have to have relative Shanti in my life. I cannot create a Shanti anywhere and everywhere I go, or because of other people have lot of Ashanti in my life. So for this Vyavaharika Satyam, for me to interact with the world, Dharma is my framework. Universal laws and principles, which I really actually don't want to follow, but I see the value of Dharma and I bring Dharma into my interactions, my roles, the way in which I fulfill responsibilities, so on and so forth. By following Dharma, I see that I am greater than my raga and dvesha. I can't stand this office colleague, but I have to work together because we have certain project deliverables. The dharma of the situation demands that I keep aside my dvesha, my irritation, my annoyance, my disgust of this person, and I do what is required for the project. If I am not following Dharma, then I am of course struggling with a lot of stress. I might also do some jadu tona. You know, if it becomes too much for me, I can't handle this guy. I could, lead a smear campaign. Of course, it won't be called a smear campaign. But I will say, you know, I know something about this fellow you don't know. You want to know? I'll tell you. And create hell for this person. Why? Because I don't like this guy. So the way in which I interact may be determined by my raga dvesha, but if I come to the Bhagavad Gita, then I discover that my raga dvesha is my subjectivity. And unless I see the limitation of my subjectivity, unless I see that by holding on to my raga, my craving for something, I love this, I love that, I love you, I love chocolate, same level. Unless I see the limitation of my subjectivity, I cannot value objectivity. By holding on to my craving, I want this person to be exactly like this. That's a raga, not raga titan. I want the person to be like this. The person is not like this. And I am experiencing so much conflict because of that. All my prayers are so that this person changes. I go for Tirtha Yatra. I go to Kumbh Mela also. Please change my partner, change my child. It sounds good. You are very spiritual. You are doing a lot of prayers. Very nice. For what? For fulfillment of your raga, which may change. If I continue to hold on to that raga determines how happy or unhappy I am. So the remote control of my happiness lies now in another situation, another condition, and I limit myself by that condition. So now I am a puppet in the strings of my, the puppeteer are my raga dveshas. And because of the raga dveshas, there are a lot of blocks, emotional blocks we have, which manifest in terms of different sensations, like a heavy chest, sometimes in the form of a disease, sometimes in terms of sensations that you experience, so on and so forth. At a cognitive level, we can try to modify, change our thoughts, become more objective. Sometimes, and very often, this also has a manifestation in our sensations in the body and in the way in which the prana flows through the body. And so, for me to discover relative peace, relative ananda, relative harmony with the world, when I do energy work, I am using this energy work as a sadhana. So when I'm doing, some energy work, moving the energy from the Mooladhara Chakra, so on and so forth, it is a sadhana for Antakarna Shuddhi. In the language of Shakti, you know, all the Shakti Upasakas, the whole Devi tradition, Brahman will be revealed, unfolded, as Shiva meeting Shakti, Purusha Prakriti. It's a presentation. So if Ganapati is all pervasive, why I am focusing only on one part of my body? I am not able to see that Ganapati is all pervasive. Because I have a lot of emotional blocks. And so this sadhana, not everyone needs it. Okay? Not everyone needs it. It is there in the Shastra, it is there in the tradition. So, as the energy moves in my body, as the prana moves across my body, there is a lot of energy release and basically a lot of emotional blocks that get resolved. Even through simple movement, that happens. So, earlier we were a little shy. Dancing in public, no way. Then thanks to puja, people very hesitantly looking at each other. I am not going to join. Oh, you're joining? Oh, okay, maybe. But I don't know how to dance. It's a block, correct? It's a defense. There was no dancing competition. And everyone is wondering how the other is dancing. Initially, I can't dance like that one. That person is moving so freely. All these ideas, okay? These are all our blocks actually. Because you're not allowing yourself to flow with the moment. Then you started to relax. Then people were laughing. And then it didn't matter if you looked silly, you didn't look silly, you didn't care. You're having a good time. Okay? through simple movement, you didn't have to learn any extraordinary Kathak, Bharatanatyam steps. You just were flowing with the moment. No conditions, no limits. You wanted to stand on your head also, you could have done. Okay. You flow with it. The blocks that you have kept. See, the idea may be a block in your head. Okay. Blockhead. But it manifests as tightness in the chest, butterflies in the stomach. Because every thought has a corresponding sensation. And so when you do something, when there is movement, the external movement is possible because of the way prana moves, or the kind of energy cultivation that you have done releases, moves through, pierces through the blocks. And that's why for relative antakarna shuddhi, antakarna shuddhi as in a certain clear, relaxed, alert mind that you can command, that is free from the hold of raga and dvesha. That is the only impurity we have, really speaking. Okay, it is an as though impurity. Why? Because it prevents me from seeing the truth. So only for that reason we will do the sadhana. So that I am able to see the absolute that I really am. Yeah? Now is matlab ka baat, which is that why should I even do this? Atharvasheersha Upanishad. For what? Sometimes I wonder whether Phalashruti should be mentioned at the beginning, you know, because it adds to the motivation. And then when you look at it, you say, oh, actually, maybe I should have paid a little more attention to this. Itna sab milega, my God. So, etad atharvasheersha. So, the ones who study it, adhite, they discover their oneness with Brahman. Sab brahma bhuyaya kalpate. What about sukha here? Haan, wo bhi hai. Only little, no. Sarvataha sukha medhate. And very important, the vigna. We are on page 11. Sarva vignai badhyate. So we saw there may be different ways in which the vigna nasha takes place. Okay? So all of that is negated. Then you say you are a big papi. No problem. Pancha maha papa. Even if you have committed the five great papas, what are they? One is killing a person. Second is eating of meat. Okay, so there is hope for the non-vegetarians. Then third, if you have had an extramarital affair, now this is very important. This is not a license to do all the papa and then chant every day. Okay, it will just neutralize, there's no use. Third is infidelity towards your partner. Fourth, papa is stealing. Okay, stealing, obviously, taking something that is not yours. Stealing of ideas, this is very big nowadays in the knowledge economy, and claiming it to be yours. Huh? Then, of course, the fifth one is you enjoy the company of all these people who steal, who kill people, who eat meat, and who have extramarital affairs, or in the name of sexual exploration, have sexual orgies without the consent of their partner. So we have had to counsel such people also, that what to do, because my husband wants threesome, foursome. I don't want, but I am married to this fellow, what shall we do? Dharma sankat. Dharma sankat kidhar hai? If one partner is not consenting, of course it is dharma sankat. Okay? No, The person wants to do the right thing for the wife. The person wants to do the right thing, be the wife. Correct? So that is her, as a wife, should I go along with this or not? Adharma mein toh sankat hi sankat hai. Adharma synonym is sankat. Correct? So anyway, these five papas that are there, you will get release from it. What it really means is that, obviously, abstain from it. But this is the beauty of our culture. There are no commandments, right? It's just saying, you do this action, you will have this consequence. Take it or leave it. Always ensuring your own responsibility, your own sense of agency. You are chanting the Ganapati Gayatri. Then naturally you are thinking clearly. So we are only pointing, you do this action, this is the consequence. Okay, this is very big papa, please you release yourself from it first by not doing the papa. By chance, agar ho gaya hai, in your younger, more foolish days, then even if you have gone through all this, now little more wisdom has dawned, no problem, because this, by chanting this with the understanding, you are free from this papa, which means that the kind of suffering that's going to be in your life is going to be much less. Then whatever papa you do during the day, divaskritam papam, nashayati, when, if you chant this Upanishad in the evening, then if you have chanted, if you have done papa during Ratri kritam papa, then if you chant this Upanishad in the morning, then whatever papa you have done, you have released from that. Then throughout the day, whatever you have done, basically pointing out to the fact that whatever papa you do during day, night, anytime, you are released from it. And dharma, artha, kama, moksham, chaturvidha purushartha, you will gain. Idam atharvashirsham shishyaya nadeyam. Now this is a instruction for the teacher. Whom, that you should not teach this to whom? The one who has lot of moha, confused thinking, and who doesn't have any shraddha towards this Upanishad. Don't teach it. It's also there. An equivalent of it is there in the Bhagavad Gita also in the 18th chapter, that don't share this with someone who will doubt it, who doesn't trust you, who has, you know, there are two, three things that are mentioned. If the person doesn't have value for it, just because you want to listen to your own voice, please don't. Okay? Then, if you chant this 1,000 times, then of course you will gain whatever you want. Then we continue. So now suddenly Ganapati Atharvashirsha sound beginning to sound more attractive. Huh? So this devotee who is a Ganapati Bhakta by now, if the person does Abhisheka with water, I mean, there are so many dravyas that are possible. Anena Ganapatim Abhishinchati, the person will become an orator. Vagmi Bhavati. So, can use the power of words to create change and backed up with a lot of scholarship. On the day of Chaturthi, so the fourth day after the new moon or the full moon, either Vinayaka Chaturthi or Sankashti, if the person does japa or chants this Upanishad, sa vidyavan bhavati. So the one who has vidyavan bhavati also will become very famous. Maybe some of these YouTubers may have done this in their Purva Janma. Na? So what is the claim to fame? You are a YouTuber. You are talking about your life. You are showing images and videos of what you are doing. So you have a particular skill? No. But my life. I am a YouTuber. I am an influencer. Okay? Lot of fame. Millions. The subscribers run into millions. So anyway, if you were to chant this, you will become famous for the right reasons. Yashovanavati. Now who is saying all this? This is Atharvana Vakyam. Okay? So don't think I'm joking about this. I am just repeating the words of Atharva Rishi. So Ganaka Rishi, but which is there in the larger Atharvaveda. Na bibheti kadachaniti. Because of this vidya, this Ganaka Rishi and this Ganesha Vidya puts an end to duality. Because why is it that I have fear? The fear could be of public speaking. The fear could be about a possible decision. The fear could be about an ant that has entered my ear. The fear could be of a blood test that I am due to go for because a doctor suspects something. The fear may be of my father-in-law, mother-in-law. Whatever the fear is, the fear exists because there is the other, whoever or whatever that other is. That other, which happens to have a form and a function, is that really the other? Because all forms, and therefore function, responsibility, role, so on and so forth, have come from the formlessness that is Brahman. So I have to deal with so many fears. What shall we do? One fear I handled. Now one more fear. My God, my whole life is going to go in handling fears. This is too much. You do whatever you need to do despite the fear. Fear is not our problem. Our problem is not doing. That despite the fear, when you do, courage is not the absence of fear. Courage is what you do in spite of the fear. And then suddenly you find, oh yeah, okay, what was the big deal? I could manage. The fear is no longer bigger than you. Earlier the fear was like looming large and totally overwhelming you. Whatever be the fear. So we live a life of courage. The real courage, absolute fearlessness, comes from recognizing the truth. Advaita Brahma, which is you. And so here this part of the mantra is mentioned even in Taittiriya. So whatever fear, don't worry so much about managing the fear. You learn to live in courage. Fears are pretty much managed. But still there might be a little instinctive fear. Because that identification with body mind is still there. When will that go? How will that go? When avidya goes. So with that vidya, there's no place for fear. Then how else to worship? If you worship with durva, blades of grass, like over here, the whoever has done it is going to get lot of wealth. Okay. Vaishravana upama bhavati. So Kubera will become your best friend, will live with you. Lot of wealth. Okay. Then if you offer prasad in terms of that beaten rice, you know that poha, beaten, yeah? Then you will gain lot of fame. So, but if you are doing lot of papa and you are chanting this, you will become infamous. Your papa will become public. Okay, so that's why you better watch out. Huh, what? Ah, exactly, beaten like the rice. Then medhavan bhavati. So that capacity, that the intelligence and a retentive power in terms of memory, that you are able to look at a topic from different standpoints, but you can do that only if you remember things. Okay, so don't worry, you have medhavan. And if you worship with 1,000 modak, okay, then whatever you want, vanchita phalam, whatever you want. So now we know where people are going to head this Ganapati, Ganesh Chaturthi. Suddenly modaks are going to be in short supply. Whatever you want will be given. Then, and then if in the Ganapati Homa, so this samit, these twigs that are there, if they are dipped in ghee, so as a part, don't just dip and offer, okay? As a part of the Homa, there is a particular protocol to it. And as it is offered, because the Agni has to be in a particular way, there is a lot of points that are mentioned. How it is to be poured, how much is to be poured, what is to be chanted when it is poured, so on and so forth. So when it is done, yatha shastram, sa sarvam labhate, you gain sarvam, not 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever needs to be gained, gaining that by which you have gained everything, gaining that the understanding that you are indeed that satyam, and you are the one that is in and through all the mithya. And so mithya is not a problem for you. You enjoy the world. The world is not a source of misery. You embrace the world. With your upadhi, you embrace the world, because the world is really you. The tree and the plant and the person and your in-law and your husband and your wife and your child and even your enemy is you. It's just a form. But a form and a name doesn't mean two entities. Just a form. It's an appearance in you. So sarvam labhate, sarvam labhate, repeated twice to indicate that we complete the Upanishad. So as is the convention, we will repeat twice, but I noticed there is one more anuvaka, so don't worry, we have last anuvaka. So if this we teach to ashtav brahmanan, so 8 brahmins, then what? One will become even greater than Surya. So this is the recipe for glow, Surya Varchasvi. So Brahma Tejas, so the brilliance, okay, certain brilliance. I'm joking about it, but what I mean to say is that one will gain the fame and the greatness of Surya. If you were to chant this with the understanding of the meaning during solar eclipse, especially at, you know, near Mahanadi, near a river, maybe Ganga or any other, while standing in the river and worshipping, then Mahavignat, so greatest obstacles you are now released from. Either you, the obstacles don't worry you, they don't affect you, because you are now used to obstacles in your life, or they just move away. Mahadoshat, whatever papa you have done, you are released from that. Mahapapat pramuchyate, I needed to do my nitya puja, so many daily prayers, I never knew. So now what? Don't worry, you chant this. Of course, you learn to chant it properly with the swara. If you are not able to, there are 2 or 3 of us that can teach this, maybe more. So learn it properly with the swara. But if you're not able to do that, then just read it. Okay, just read it without being creative and adding your own tune. Okay, for the sake of melody. No. It is Vedic. It has to be chanted in this way because this is the way it was revealed. So we are not interested in our own creativity here. Sa sarvavid bhavati, sa sarvavid bhavati. Being sarvavid is really understanding that I am that satyam. Ganapati is that satyam. And that this entire manifestation, which has the status of mithya, because it is dependent, is also satyam. Okay, because wherever there is mithya, there is satyam. But I have to be able to see it as mithya, because all the forms, all the manifestations, all the roles, all the responsibilities, all the relationships, all my issues in life, they are all relative. They are incidental. They are not intrinsic. Sa sarvavid bhavati, sa sarvavid bhavati. That I now see the satyam. Ya evam veda ityupanishata. So this says this Ganapati Atharvashirsha Upanishad. So we go back to the beginning and we chant the Shanti Patha, as is the convention. Because while we may have completed the Upanishad, while we may have gone through the Upanishad, as Swami Chinmayananji said, has the Upanishad gone through me? If it is stuck in some places, we again seek grace. Om Bhadram Karne Bhishruya Vadevaha Bhadram Pashe Makshabhir Yajatraha Stire Rangai Istushtuvagum Sastanubhi Vyasheva Devahi Dayadayuhu Swastina Indro Vriddhashravaha Swastina Bhusha Vishvavedaha Swastina Starkshu Arishtanevihi Swastino Brahaspatir Dahatu Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Shishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.